I will share with you some thoughts towards personalized therapy in colorectal cancer. I will mainly discuss how recent gene expression arrays progress have contributed in the field. And firstly, I will discuss stage two prognostic genomic signature to guide decisions in adjuvant treatment. You know well that treatment of stage two colon and rectal patients is still debatable. The QUASAR trial showed a marginal benefit for patients randomized to receive post-surgical chemotherapy, and confirmation of old prognostic factors and addition of new prognostic factors are important to better define what patient population within the stage two rectal and colon cancer will derive the greatest benefit of chemotherapy. This QUASAR trial also involved a subgroup analysis in stage two colon cancer only, where they confirmed the prognostic value of T4 versus T3 as a clinico-pathological factor, and MSI, microsatellite instability, as a protective molecular factor. But they included in the analysis the validation of a 7-gene prognostic signatures developed by Genomic Health, by RT-PCR, that added independent prognostic information to the model, so that patients with a low risk profile had only 12% risk of relapse, whereas patients with a high risk signature had 22% risk. Another developed and validated prognostic gene signature is Coloprint, which our group at the Catalan Institute of Oncology helped validate with this series of colon and rectum cancer patients. And in particular, if you look at the stage two, you see that Coloprint yielded prognostic information. Those with low risk had 90.9% progression-free survival, and those with high risk had 73.9% relapse-free survival.